Hello everyone, here is CRH Films, sit back as we begin. Herschel Greenbaum lives in Eastern Europe in a town called Sloopsk. He makes his living digging ditches. One day Herschel meets Sara at the market and immediately falls in love with her. She is poor and cannot buy normal food to impress the girl. Herschel works twice as hard. With the money he makes, he buys a smoked fish and gives it to Sara. They start dating and spend a lot of time together. Sara shares her dreams with Herschel, saying that she dreams of becoming rich. Herschel, on the other hand, wants to try sparkling water someday. They realize that they love each other, so they have to get married. Immediately after the wedding, the town is attacked by the bloodthirsty Cossacks and all the houses are burned down. But the Greenbaums do not give up. They sail to the United States and begin life there anew. Herschel gets a job at a pickle factory. He is hired to kill rats with a special beater. Despite his hard work, he still cannot afford sparkling water. But another joyous event happens in the life of the young family. Sara gets pregnant. Shortly before the birth, Herschel swears to her that the Greenbaums will become great and achieve a lot. Then he goes to work where the rats all start running at him. They drive Herschel onto a bridge and he falls into a barrel with marinade. The factory workers do not notice it. At the same time, the foreman tells them that the factory is closing. The workers close the barrel and leave, so Herschel was marinating for 100 years until the barrel was opened by random teenagers. Greenbaum is recognized as a medical miracle. He learns from the scientists that his entire family is dead. The only descendant, Ben, is left. They contact him and Ben takes the Herschel to him. Ben's ancestor is amazed at how rich his great-grandson lives. He even has a water carbonation machine. However, Ben did not become a doctor or a lawyer. He is a freelancer who has developed an app that determines how ethical the company that created this or that product is, called a Bubop app. Herschel asks Ben to show him pictures of his son and Ben's own parents. It turns out they are already dead. The next day, Herschel takes his great-grandson to the cemetery where he bought a plot of land for his family 100 years ago. The area looks neglected. It now belongs to another man, and an advertising billboard towers over the graves. While Herschel reads a prayer over Sarah's grave, Ben digs into his phone. Even though he is Jewish and not very religious and does not know the words of the prayer, workers arrive to change the image on the billboard. When Herschel sees that they are putting up a vodka billboard, he thinks it was ordered by his worst enemies, the Cossacks. He tries to make the workers stop, but they refuse and he has to use force. Not willingly, he gets into a fight and they are both sent to the police, from where they manage to get out only after posting bail. At home, Herschel insists that Ben buy back the land and remove the billboard that killed the tree that used to grow there. However, Ben does not have that much money. Herschel demands that Ben finally contact investors with his application, then they will have the money. So Ben contacts an investor he knows. He even arranges a meeting with him, but during the conversation he refuses to invest because of his recent arrest. It is important to him that the creator of the app has a clean reputation. When Ben returns home, he pounces on Herschel and tells him everything, as it was because of him that he was arrested. Herschel starts yelling at his great-grandson and swears that he will make money himself and buy back the billboard. After the argument, Herschel leaves. He decides to create a trading empire by pickling and selling cucumbers. He goes to the store and brings a basket of cucumbers to the cash register and finds out that it is too expensive to buy them, so Herschel goes into the dump and finds salt, cucumbers, and dirty jars. Then he goes to the park and begins to prepare cucumbers for pickling. He has to wait for rain, since he didn't have any water. After the downpour, the jars are filled with water and the finished product can be sold. He goes to one of the streets of the city and begins to sell his creations. Herschel with the cucumbers is noticed by two modern guys. They have always been for environmentally friendly products, so they readily buy handmade cucumbers. Moreover, they are excited by the image and manner of Herschel. They posted a video about him in social networks and the video got millions of views. Ben meanwhile despaired to earn something from his. However, he saw the video of Herschel being watched in a bar and learned that Greenbaum's products are very popular. From the interview he learns that Herschel is pouring rainwater into a jar, which is not hygienic. Out of envy, Ben calls the health department and reports on violations committed by street vendors. After an inspection, Herschel is issued a large fine. He is upset. Sitting down on the sidewalk, he understands that he alone cannot raise his business to the necessary heights, but his first customers approach him and advise him to hire interns because they are ready to work for free. Herschel does so. Students and other young people help him to comply with all sanitary norms in the production of products. After that, the trade goes very well. Ben too wasted no time editing the appendix and approaching investors again, but they refused to invest money, saying that they had a more promising project, and that project turned out to be Herschel's cucumber company, and he had already saved up enough money to buy the cemetery plot and tear down the billboard. But he has a fight with his great-grandson, and Herschel goes to visit him to tell him the good news. Ben watches a video in which his parents give him a check, the first contribution to his future company, and they jokingly ask him to name it Mom and Dad. When Herschel enters, they start arguing again. Ben is offended by Herschel's words and decides to set up his ancestor again and advises him to start posting on Twitter. Ben counts on modern society to rebel against Herschel's honest but inappropriate remarks. So Herschel Greenbaum asks his assistant to post a few tweets, and in the morning an angry mob of offended Americans comes to him. Such a public outcry draws the attention of the press. Herschel gets invited to TV to give a frank interview. The host interprets Herschel's words in his own way, which gives him some public and political weight. Ben sees all this and realizes that his scheme has failed. He has failed again to prevent Herschel. He is even invited to appear on stage to take part in a debate with a public figure. The debate was short, after which the hosts began to take questions from the audience, to which Herschel successfully answered until Ben rose from his seat. He changed his voice and sat farther away so that his great-grandfather could not recognize him. He asked a question about Christianity in a Jewish school. Herschel spoke negatively about it, for which the audience of the show chased him away. After this, Greenbaum Sr. was decided to deport him from the country. They want to send him back to Sloopsk. Herschel hides for a while and then shows up at Ben's house. The relative asks him to accompany him to the Canadian border. Herschel intends to move to Canada. He does not want to go back to Sloopsk. Ben agrees. He brings him to the woods, then escorts him to the border. Ben had the idea of leaving his great-grandfather in these woods, but he brushes it off at night. Herschel sees that Ben is cold and hugs him to warm him up. And in the morning they go out to the road. A border patrol car shows up and they have to hide. While they were hiding from the border guards, Ben developed warm feelings for his ancestor and told him what he had done. He told him about calling the inspectors, asking provocative questions of the audience, and specifically advising him to write on Twitter to get people mad at Herschel, for which Herschel starts beating up his great-grandson at the noise the border guards come. Herschel takes Ben's things and leaves him behind. In his backpack, he finds a haircutting machine and shaves off his beard. He changes into Ben's clothes and pretends to be him, but Ben himself is turned in to the frontier guards disguised as Greenbaum. The elder Ben is tried and deported to his hometown of Sloopsk. Herschel, on the other hand, moves into his apartment. There he finds a little drawing of Ben where he has signed his father's name Bob and his mother Bob. Herschel realizes that his descendant has not forgotten about his family. On the contrary, he tries to make the name Greenbaum famous and even names his application after his parents. After which he decides to go to him. In Sloopsk, Ben is having a hard time, and to get warm he goes to the local synagogue. They are going to read a prayer for the dead and they need another Jew for the ceremony. Ben confesses that he does not know the words of the prayer, but they take him anyway. When they finish reading the prayer and go away, Ben sees Herschel. He came to take him to the USA, but before he leaves he takes his great-grandson to the place where he liked to spend time with Sara. Together they devise a family business. Herschel is about to apologize so that the Americans forget what he said. They come back to the USA and Herschel starts to make their cucumbers. Ben also creates a website for their sale, and they are going to pickle not only cucumbers but also watermelons and even fruits. Having returned to the USA, they both go to the cemetery to commemorate their relatives. By Sarah's grave, Herschel plants a new tree. He starts to read a prayer and Ben joins him this time. Now they live together, watching movies with Barbara Streisand in the evenings. That was our synopsis of the movie. Subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next stories. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and leave your comments about the movie and what movie you would like to see on our channel. Have a good day or night, and see you soon.